Binomial distribution is given by p of x is equal to nc x p raised to x q raised to n minus x. This nc x, are you aware what it is? So this is like a combination. You know npr, ncr, like that. This is a combination. Okay, now here where n is nothing but number of times the experiment conducted, x is the number of times which we are getting the success. So probability of getting a success is denoted as p, and not getting p, or you can say probability of failure, is denoted by q. Altogether p plus q is 1. Okay, so this is a binomial distribution. It is given in this format. Here clearly you can see all the p of x will be greater than or equal to 0. And one more thing we have proved, if you just take a summation of p of x, the sum is equal to 1. Okay, now here we have a problem. Just see, there are two people, A and B. They play a game in which their chance of winning are 3:2. So here, what is the meaning of 3:2 is, so till now, what they have played the games, for that their chance of winning are given in the form 3:2. Maybe like some 60% chance is there for A to win, or some 40% chance is there for B to win. Okay, it is given in that format. Whenever it is given in the form of a ratio, whenever you want to find a probability, it is given by, so one more thing, we have to choose what is probability of success in each of the question. That is nothing but P. Here, this depends on the given question. You can just clearly see, find A's chance of winning at least 3 games out of 7 games played. So you are interested that A should win a game, isn't it? So P is nothing but, it's a probability that A wins a game. So this is to be found if it is given in the form of a ratio. Okay, we have to take like this. So always probability is given by favorable divided by total. So total number, you can say 3 plus 2, in that favorable for A is 3. So it becomes 3 divided by 5. Similarly, Q is nothing but 1 minus P. You can take like that, or even you can find out with the help of this ratio. Q is nothing but probability that B wins a game. What is this ratio given as? This is like 3:2 means, what is the chance that Q will win the match? It is favorable is 2 divided by total number is 5. Okay. Now let us see the two more quantities. Whenever you deal with binomial distribution, you should fix your N, you should fix your P and Q. So P and Q are done. Let us see what is N. N is number of times the experiment is conducted. Here, this is like how many games are being played? There are 7 games. Am I right? Altogether, 7 games are being played. So total number of games are nothing but, now here trials means N is equal to 7. X is a variable. X is a variable. Now, X will take any value between 0 to 7. Agree with this? X is what? Number of times A is going to win. So here, out of 7 matches played, A may not win any match. Possibility is 0. He may win 1 match, like that. Maximum he may win 7 matches. I can't go beyond 7. Is this part clear? X will take any value between 0 to 7. It cannot be negative, because we can't say negative match, a negative number of times he is winning. That is a wrong concept. Okay. Now, if you see this part asked, find A's chance of winning at least 3 games. What is the meaning at least 3 means? It is probability of X greater than or equal to 3. Minimum is 3. Am I right with this, or it should be X less than or equal to 3? This. At least, see, I want a group of students containing at least 3 students means, how you will form? Will you form a group of 3, less than 3, or more than 3? How you will form it? If I say a condition like that. a team comprising at least three members. So can I take less than three? Less than three will not be the correct way, right? It will be either equal to three or greater than equal to three. So the word at least and at most should be very much clear. This is where some students get confused. Now, if you just see from three till the last one, you have got five values. But before three, you have got three values. So instead of going for five, if you take a complement, it will be very easy. So what is the complement of this? 1 minus probability of x less than 3. Less than 3. Now, less than 3 means what are the values? And one more thing, very important thing. This is minus outside, so better take a bracket. Because in bracket, you have got more than one term. Okay? What are the values of x less than 3? It is 0, 1, and 2. So this is what we have taken. Now, if you just recall the problems, we have dealt with a problem where table is given. Do you have any probability function defined till now in this problem? Can you see a probability function P of X defined?
No, ma'am.
No. So we are going to define it. So this X is taking now whole number value, isn't it? So whole number means it belongs to discrete random variable. Now, what is the value of N here? N is 7. Is it less than 30?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so it is less than 30 means you can go for a binomial distribution. If this N value, what you have taken here, if it is 30 or more than 30, you cannot apply binomial. It becomes very tedious work. Okay, so now let us apply binomial distribution. So just actually before this only we should have written, let it be. Now here I'll just manage. Therefore, by binomial distribution, can you tell me the general format? How P of X is given? Have you not written binomial distribution? NCX, P raised to X, Q raised to N minus X, am I right? See here. Binomial distribution is given by this. You see in that this box, it's written. It's a particular format of a PDF. Okay, we are applying binomial distribution, so we have to take this function only. Okay, yeah. Now here, what is N? See, what are the things fixed? N, P, X are fixed. X is going to change. Am I right? So now you have to substitute N, P and X over here. What is N? What is the value of N in this problem? 7. Am I right? Please answer. 7CX. What is my P? P is 3 by 5, isn't it? How you have here? P raised to X. So 3 by 5 raised to X. And then Q raised to N minus X. Yeah, what is Q? Here only just try to manage. This is Q is 2 by 5 raised to 7 minus X. Am I correct? So this P of X, we have to use it. Now if I take X equal to 0 means in this expression where all X is there, you have to take it as 0. You will get probability of X equal to 0. Clear? Similarly, how can I obtain probability of X equal to 1? How to obtain it? In the same function P of X, where all X is there, take it as 1. Similarly, take X equal to 2, you will get probability of X equal to 2. Are you getting now?
Yes, ma'am.
Now. See, so P of X is given by this. Take for X equal to 0. So how many places X is there? 1, 2, 3. In all these X, take it as 0. So 7C0. 3 by 5 raised to 0. Help me in writing this. 2 by 5 raised to 7 minus 0. Yeah, this is probability of X equal to 0. Plus, write the same function by taking X equal to 1. Tell me. 7C1. 3 by 5 raised to 1. 2 by 5 raised to 7 minus 1. Okay, directly if you want, you can write it as 6. No problem. One more quantity, probability of x equal to 2. So 7c2, 3 by 5 raised to 2, 2 by 5 raised to how much? 7 minus 2 means 5. Yeah, all of you take the calculator. Tell me term by simplification value. See, 7c0 is 1. 3 by 5 raised to 0 is also 1. You have to calculate 2 by 5 raised to 7. That is the value of the first term. Take in calculator, 2 by 5 raised to 7. Tell me the answer.
Ma'am, 0.0016.
0.0016. 16. Okay. Similarly, 7C1 is 7. Even you can take this in calculator. There is a button where which will give you the combination values. Just search for that. 7C1 is 7. 3 by 5, 7 into 3 by 5 into 2 by 5 raised to 6. Answer. All of you operate the calculator. This is very short example. This will give you 6 to 7 marks.
Ma'am, 0.0172.
Okay. Next. All of you apply it. Okay. Apply. Use the calculator and tell me if you are getting same or are you getting different. Next, 7C2 into 3 by 5. I think 7C2 will be 14. Not sure. Just check. 3 by 5.
21, ma'am.
21 it will be. Okay. Yeah, take it. Calculate this. You should know how to take it in a calculator. Otherwise, it will take longer time. Tell me which is the button which will give me combination values.
Division. Shift and division.
Shift and division. Okay. Yeah. On top of that, you can see NCR. Right? Am I right? Shift and division. That will ask you NCR. Tell me the third term value.
0.077.
Yeah, others, same answer. Same answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, how to apply that 7C2, if you want to find out, first you should press 7, then press shift division, then you should press 2, 7C2. Correct, no? Same procedure? I think in MS, in ES it is direct, maybe. Okay, in MS
yes.
You should take. What is the answer? 1 minus sum of these all terms. 0.0958.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Check everybody. Just check.
This is
0.9042.
9042 total, ma'am.
Ma'am, 0.9042.
Okay. 9042.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll try to tell you the meaning of this, what we calculated actually, practically what it means. So suppose like here, have you just in the commentary, you hear about the chance of winning some particular game and all that, no? Like this here, just we are finding a predicted value. We are just giving some prediction. It may not be 100% right. It is not 0% wrong. So you can say this is like some prediction. I'm just predicting the value. So what is the question asked? Find A's chance of winning at least 3 games out of 7 games played means if A and B are playing opposite of each other, then if suppose seven games are being played then I can say that 90% chance is there for A to win at least 3 matches out of 7 played. This is what it means. Are you getting it? 90% chance is there that A is going to win at least 3 matches out of 7 games played. Okay. Let me just go to the next example. We have a question here where 6 coins are tossed. Find the probability of getting exactly 3 heads, at most 3 heads, and at least 3 heads, and one more condition, at least 1 head. Okay. Now, if you see this part, how many coins are being tossed?
6, ma'am.
6. So that means you have to take the value of n as 6. Is it clear? Number of times means here it is actually conducted only once, but 6 coins are being tossed. N is equal to 6. Again, this is a quantity less than 30. Let us use a binomial. Okay. Now, if you read out the conditions given, what is the success for us? Getting a head or getting a tail?
Getting a head.
Getting a head.
Getting
so head. P, we'll write it as, what is P now? Probability of getting head. Probability of getting head. Now here, when you take this, you should consider it for one toss. Okay, not for all the tosses. What is the probability of getting a head in one toss? Total number of outcomes are?
6.
2. Correct. When you toss one coin, what are the outcomes? Either you may get head or tail, right? What is, how many faces are favorable? Yes, 1/2 always. It is true, right? Probability of getting a head is 1/2. Similarly, what will be Q then? Q can be taken as 1 - P. Or you can say that it, that is probability of getting a tail, isn't it? What is the value? Isn't it half again? Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, now P, N, P, Q are fixed. Now, tell me what X is going to take, the values. X may be 0. What is the meaning X is 0 means? Okay, if you want, you can just specify what X is denoting. So, X is nothing but, let X denote the number of head of, the number of heads obtained when 6 coins are tossed. 6 coins are tossed. Okay, now what X is going to take the values? What X is going to take the values? X will take 0 to
6.
0 to 6. Okay, one second. Just a minute. So, X will take any value between 0 to 6. By binomial distribution, we have NCX, P raised to X, Q raised to N minus X. Substitute for N, P, and Q. To simplify, this is our binomial distribution for the problem. Just tell me, any one of you, what is the first condition they have asked?
Exactly 3 heads.
Yeah. So this is, now we call it as probability of getting exactly 3 heads. So what is the meaning? So getting the number of heads is denoted as X. So this is probability of X and 3. What is the relation between them? Exactly 3 means? Is it less, greater, or equal? Not equal. It is only equal, exactly 3.
Equal.
Yes. So, what are the values of X which is equal to 3? How many values you have? How many values?
Only one.
Only one. Very
only
good.
One.
Yeah. So, in this box value, know where all X is there, take it as 3. How many places you have X? Only one. Correct? So, this is nothing but C6, 3, 1/2 raised to 6. Calculate it and tell me the answer. Again,
0.312.
Ma'am, I'm getting 0.3125.
3125. Others, same answer?
Yes, ma'am, same answer.
Okay. So what is the meaning again? There is 31% chance is there that in all the, when six coins are being tossed, so exactly three heads, what I'm going to get, this is like predicted value. 31%, I'm sure. I cannot be 100% or 0%. Got it? Let us take the next one. What is the second one they have asked? Probability of getting, what it is?
At most three heads.
At most three heads. What is the meaning at most? Is it maximum or minimum?
Minimum.
Less than or equal to three.
Yeah. Maximum three. Maximum three means here you can take, okay, it is less than or equal to three, means you cannot go beyond three. Am I right? At the most three. So you can go till three or less than three. Clear? Now, what are the values of x which are less than or equal to three? What they are? Zero,
one, two, three.
So if you want, take it as a complement. Complement means other three values will come, or else you can proceed ahead like this. What shall I do? Only one extra calculation. What shall I do? As it is?
Complement.
Okay, take complement. So this is, what is the complement of x greater less than or equal to 3? 1 minus probability of x greater than 3. Greater than 3. So what are the values greater than 3? Tell me in this x, what are the values greater than 3?
4, 5, 6.
6. So we'll write it as 1 minus, okay, 1 minus probability of x equal to 4, probability of x equal to 5, plus probability of x equal to 6. Yeah, just calculate it. Now again, use this form. One thing what you can do, in all these terms, what will come? When I substitute for P of x, which term is going to come in all? Same.
1 by 2 whole raised to 6.
Yeah. So that I will keep it out. 1 by 2 raised to 6, I'll keep it out. Why to write 3 times? Then I take x equal to 4. If x is 4, what will get? 6c4. Plus, if I take x equal to 5, x equal to 5 means 6c5. And this is 6c6. Correct? Just we are taking x as 4, 5, 6. This calculation will be easier for you to do. Tell me the value. Fast.
0.6406.
6406, huh? No, is it 06? I did not hear the last digit.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there is 64% chances there that you may get at the most three heads. These are some probability values what we are calculating. What is the third condition? Anybody has any doubt, you can just tell me in between. I'll just stop and explain it. Huh? Please, these problems are very important. These are very simple, very easy things are there. Huh? But you should understand. Probability of getting at least, what it is? Three heads, no? At least three heads means three is minimum or maximum value? At least three.
Minimum.
Minimum. Means you should start from three till the last. You can say greater than or equal to three. Correct? Okay. Now, greater than or equal to 3 means how many values?
1 minus
3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, better take complement. So, 1 minus probability of x less than 3. This is 1 minus. What are the values less than 3? 0.
Ma'am.
Huh.
Second one answer 0.656, ma'am.
Yes.
Same answer.
6562. Why Tirtharaj is getting different answers? 6562.
625.
Mine is wrong, ma'am. Mine is wrong.
That's what you are agreeing it is wrong. Why you are calculating wrong value is my question. Don't make too hurry so that if answer is wrong, no use. Correct? So what are x less than 3? 0, 1, 2 and 3, no? Shall I include 3?
No, ma'am.
No, only till 2 we have to take. Okay. Yeah, take it now. Again, same thing. What can we take for this example? 1 by 2 raised to 6 out. If you take x equal to 0, you will get 6c0, 6c1, 6c2. Yeah, do the calculation. Correct answer you tell. 0 point. One more thing. See, I'm confidently writing 0 point because it should be a positive value less than 1. Whatever probability value you take. Tell me fast, what is this?
From same as above.
6562 only?
Yes, ma'am.
I think so, yeah. We have one property, no? NCR is equal to NCN minus R, most probably. Three values here, 3. 3, 6, 5, 6, 2. Okay. We have one more, right? What is that? The last one. Probability of getting? What they've asked? See the fourth part.
At least one head.
At least one head. From the coin. Okay. At least one head means is one minimum or maximum? At least.
Minimum.
Minimum. Minimum means I have to take it as greater than or equal to 1 or less than or equal to 1.
Greater than or equal to.
Greater than or equal to. See, you have to start from 1 and onwards. Okay. Now, obviously, 1 and onwards is you have to take from 1 to 6. Instead of that, best for this is
complement.
Complement. So, tell me what are the values of x which are less than 1 here? Less than 1 is only 0, right? Yes. This calculation is going to be easier if you take it. So, it is left to you whether you have to take complement or you have to take directly. You need to think it. Okay. Yeah. So six C zero, 1/2 raised to 6. Answer is, I think you'll get
9844.
This is probability of x greater than or equal to 1. Yeah. Do check. Are you getting, feeling binomial theorem to be easy? See, only thing you should understand and take it correctly. There is no problem. You will definitely, you can solve the problem related to this. Okay? Okay. Let me take another next variety. A die is thrown. Eight times. Actually, I think so. Die is a singular form and dice is a plural form. Am I right, English medium students? Dice is a singular, plural. Die is a singular. Okay. That is not the question. Let us solve mathematical part. Probability. Okay. Probability that 3 falls. Take like this. 3 falls exactly 2 times, at least once, and third, at most 7 times. Okay. Okay. So again, what is the n here? What is the quantity n?
Eight,
right. So again, this is, so when you throw a dice, no die, then you will get it as either 1 times, 2 times, 3 times, like a whole number. That is not a fractional. So obviously, this belongs to first thing DRV, discrete. Next thing, as n is equal to 8 less than 30, this problem belongs to binomial distribution. Got it? Okay, let us solve, because they have not mentioned which distribution to be applied. Here, the value of n is nothing but 8. Now, again, x will take what value? See, a die is thrown 8 times. X is nothing but probability. Okay, what is the probability of success here? With what you are interested in? What you call 3/4, right? So probability that that number 3 falls. Okay, means whenever you throw it. So what are the total number of outcomes are there for a die? How many faces six. Are there? There are 6. So how many faces are favorable of getting 3?
1.
Isn't it only 1? Yeah. So 1/6. So Q is nothing but failure means 3 shouldn't fall. Okay. That means you can take it as 1 minus P, right? Which is 1 minus 1/6 means how much? 5/6. Correct? So P and Q,
yes,
N is also fixed. Again, one more thing. X is obviously, it is like the number of times 3 falls. So X will be, what values X will take? It may take 0 to 8. Yes, very good. 0 to 8. Now, let us come to the problem. So this, if you see the question, which distribution has to be applied? Clearly, binomial distribution. Because this is giving a whole number value and this value is less than 30. Okay, what is the general format? What is the general distribution? Binomial.
N C X. P raised to X. Q raised to N minus
N minus X. Okay, now substitute for N, P, Q. 3 things we have to substitute. N is 8. P is 1/6 raised to X and Q is 5/6 raised to 8 minus X. Now tell me whether we can simplify for this P and Q here, like how we did in the previous example, 1/2. No. We cannot. Don't take any extra thing that 6 and 6 are common and let me do a simplification. Keep it like this. Not to worry. Take in calculator. If it is lengthy also, take in calculator properly. That is important. Okay, so this is what general thing we discussed. Now we have to go for the conditions. What is the first condition they have asked? Probability that 3 falls how many times?
Exactly
2 times. Means what is the relation between x and 2?
Equal, ma'am.
Yes, x is exactly equal to 2. Okay, so probability that 3 falls exactly 2 times is nothing but probability of x equal to 2. So how many values? Again, only one such value, right? Yeah. In this expression, you just take where all x is there. 3 places x you have, take it as 2. So it is 8c2, 1/6 raised to 2, 5/6 raised to what? 8 minus 2 is how much? 6. Calculate it. Again, I'm 100% sure. 0.
Mom, 2605. 2605.
Yeah?
0. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there is only 26% chances there that exactly we'll get 2 times that number 3 falls on the die. Second one. Will you try? What is the second one? At least once. Yeah, all of you just try. Probability that 3 falls at least once. at least one. So x and one are related. That is clear. At least one. So greater than or equal to one, or less than or equal to, or equal to, or not equal to.
Greater than or equal to one.
Very good. So these words should be very clear. Huh? At least, at most. Let's see. Minimum is one. So maximum, it may go till 8. Again, 100% we have to take a complement for this. Otherwise, it becomes very tedious work, right? Because 1 to 8, you have to take 8 values. 1 minus probability. Just take x equal to 0. What is the answer?
0.7674.
Yeah, 8 minus 0 means 8. So altogether, actually, it is 5 by 6 raised to 8, and take 1 minus of that quantity. What you said? 0.7?
7674.
Others, same answer?
Yes, ma'am.
So there is a 76%, 77% chance is there that 3 will fall at least once. Take the third one. What is given? At most, right? Probability that 3 falls at most, how many times? 7 times. Yeah. What is that? Complement is 1 minus probability of x greater than 7. So what are the values greater than 7?
8.
7 and
only 8. One value. Yes, that is x equal to 8. We can't go beyond 8 because 8 number of times the die is thrown only 8 times. Yeah, again, I think so. The answer is it same?
0.999.
Oh. 0.999. Okay, are you telling this value or overall value?
Overall.
Overall means if this may be 0.1 or no, something.
No, ma'am.
For this.
Substitute. Okay. Final answer is 0.2.
No, be clear with this. One second. Let me show the substitution. This is 1 minus P of x equal to 8 means you should take 8C8. How otherwise others may not understand. 8C8, then 1 by 6 raised to 8, 5 by 6 raised to 8 minus 8, 0. So 1 minus. Tell me this value. The answer is 0.9999. Next example, assume that on an average, one telephone number, this is olden days problem, because telephone, okay, telephone number out of 15 is busy. What is the probability? What is the probability that 6 randomly chosen telephone numbers okay, first condition, not more than 3. Second, at least 3 of them. At least 3 of them will be busy. So what is given here, on an average, one telephone number out of 15 is busy. So here, what is the probability of success? Let's see, what is the probability that 6 randomly chosen telephone numbers, not more than 3, at least three of them will be busy. So what is the success here? Probably.
Busy, ma'am.
Okay. Being that number to be busy. Now, one more thing. What is the value of n here?
15, ma'am.
Okay. Now, if you take 15, it will not be correct. They are not taking 15 numbers and they want us to see that not more than three or at least three of them are busy. They have chosen six randomly chosen telephone numbers. So here n is nothing but six. Try to get it. What is this 15 indicating? That on an average, suppose if you take some 15 telephone numbers, out of that, on an average, one number will be always busy. That will help us to get the probability. Are you getting it? So n is not 15 here, n is nothing but 6. So they are choosing some only 6 telephone numbers. And they want to just check whether how many, like more, not more than 3 or at least 3 of them are going to be busy. So P is nothing but probability that a number being busy. Which number? Telephone number. So what is this they have given? Total number, how many are there? 15 are there. Out of 15, how many will be busy? What is favorable of being busy? Read the first sentence. One. Is it clear?
One.
P is 1 by 15. Yeah. All of you just see this part clear. Now what is Q? Q is 1 minus P, right? What is that quantity? 14 by 15. Yeah. Again, X will be again, it may be like from, X will be from 0 to 6. Agree? X will take the value from 0 to 6.
Yes.
It is not 15. Now, what we have to use for this? Again, N is 6, less than 30. We have to use which distribution?
Binomial.
Yeah, let us use binomial distribution. What is the standard form? P of x equal to ncx, p raised to x, q raised to n minus x. So n is 6, cx, p is what? 1 by 15 raised to x, and q is 14 by 15. Raised to 6 minus x. Now, go to the conditions and just find out. Hopefully, you can find it. It is not that difficult. Shall I give some time? Try and tell me. Yeah, anybody with the answer? Triple 9 or double 9? Just check. Triple. Is it 997 or 997?
997, ma'am.
Okay, done. Next, it is at least 3 means. At least 3 means.
Greater than equal.
Yes, greater than or equal to 3. So again, you can take 3, 4, 5, 6 or better is complement, I think. Okay, here 4 values there. Okay, this will give us again 3 values, I guess. X equal to 0, X equal to 1, and X equal to 2. Just tell me, are you getting some idea how to calculate these probability values? This is actually a very interesting topic. So if you once understand this problem belongs to what category, next part is very, very easy. See, very simple calculation is there, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, the basic thing of probability is a little bit confusing, what to apply and all, but here it is straightforward. You try to distinguish between the questions, it is very easy. Yeah. What is the answer? 0 point?
Ma'am, first one.
Huh?
0.9062.
I think maximum have told me not 9997. When I did the calculation, it is 997 I wrote. Maybe 19 I have missed. Just do check, Mahesh. Your answer is wrong, actually. Be very clear with using the calculator correct way. Please.